This place is not only the place of utter shame for Germany, but also a place of utter shame for the humanity. As this is not only a memorial, but like a light tower, like a constant reminder to make us aware of like the utter danger of any form of fascism. So it is a place which has meaning, is meaningful in millions of ways, and can teach us in millions of ways about the world, about the ways of politics, about the ways of money, about the ways of fascism, of intolerance, about the utter danger of labeling things. You know, you cannot develop, you cannot extinguish millions of people individually. This, you have to make them Jews first, or Germans, or Americans, or give them a name, and then you can get to it. So this is this place is full of things which are meaningful for us, especially when you understand that, you know, that every human being comes with a way to look at the world. So if we are 50 people now, we have 50 different realities, and not everybody is aware that he has in his own hands how he sees the world. Here we see the result of people who came with a very narrow and evil vision of the world and created a utter nightmare. And we should learn by a place like this how extremely important it is for us to make a different choice. Like to devote our lifetime to something which is as far away as anyhow thinkable possible from that decision. We have the choice. We really can choose to live, to devote our lives to joy, to beauty, to teaching, to art, to love, to care. We don't have to go that. This is not a law. There is nothing given. We have the freedom to decide. And, you know, when I led the first casts, like 10 years ago, to a camp, I was so ashamed. I felt like this impact of guilt on my shoulders. It took some time to grow through all those different layers of interpretation. And now I am at a point where I see like the utter, where I celebrate the freedom. So now I would invite you to go here and see that and like to understand the extreme extension of that guilt, of this negativity, and then go from there and move and even celebrate what we are having, how we have grown, and what we are having in possibilities in our lives. There is no pressure, there are no crosses around which beat us and which torture us. And there is no limitation. Basically, we have no limitation. We should celebrate our freedom and we should use it. We should celebrate every moment. Every moment is so precious. Let us not allow like our mind to narrow us down. Let's take it as a tool for freedom, for growth and for beauty. So maybe that is a strange statement in front of a concentration camp, but I think the fathers of this camp came precisely from that idea. It's not an historic exhibition, but it is a reminder people go for the right thing and don't go in traps like these. And people do. We have concentration camps, as you know, right now on the planet. So it is all about choices again. And I'm in the middle of wonderful, blessed people who make the right choices.